So Solomon sat on the throne of his father David, and his kingdom was firmly established. Solomon loved the Lord, walking in the statutes of his father David. Only he sacrificed and offered incense at the high places. The king went to Gibeon to sacrifice there, for that was the principal high place. Solomon used to offer 1,000 burnt offerings on that altar. At Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night, and God said, "Ask what I should give you." And Solomon said, "You have shown great and steadfast love to your servant, my father David, because he walked before you in faithfulness, in righteousness, and in uprightness of heart toward you. And you have kept for him this great and steadfast love, and have given him a son to sit on his throne today. And now, O Lord, my God, you have made your servant king in place of my father David. Although I am only a little child, I do not know how to go out or come in. And your servant is in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a great people, so numerous they cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding mind to govern your people, able to discern between good and evil. For who can govern this, your great people?" It pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this. God said to him, "Because you have asked this and have not asked for yourself long life or riches or for the life of your enemies, but have asked for yourself understanding to discern what is right, I now do according to your word. Indeed, I give you a wise and discerning mind. No one like you has been before you, and no one like you shall arise after you. I give you also what you have not asked, both riches and honor all your life. No other king shall compare with you. If you will walk in my ways, keeping my statutes and my commandments, as your father David walked, then I will lengthen your life." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 111. Please respond after the asterisk. Hallelujah, I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart.
In the assembly of the upright, in the congregation.
Great are the deeds of the Lord.
They are studied by all who delight in them.
His work is full of majesty and splendor.
And his righteousness endures forever.
He makes his marvelous works to be remembered.
The Lord is gracious and full of compassion.
He gives food to those who fear him.
He is ever mindful of his covenant.
He has shown his people the power of his works,
in giving them the lands of the nations.
The works of his hands are faithfulness and justice.
All his commandments are sure.
They stand fast forever and ever.
Because they are done in truth and equity.
He sent redemption to his people. He commanded his covenant forever.
Holy and awesome is his name.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Those who act accordingly have good understanding. His grace endures forever.
The second reading is from Paul's epistle to the Ephesians. Be careful how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Thanks be to God. I am the bread. Okay.
according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
God, may the words of my lips and the meditations of our hearts be pleasing to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen. Amen.
For the last 3 weeks, including today, we have been hearing the words from the epistle to the Ephesians. And in it, we are reminded that we are called with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. We are reminded that we are all one. We are one in the Spirit of God, that dwells in us and among us, and that each of us are given by God unique gifts to build up that body of Christ. That not all of us have the same gifts, but in building up the unique gifts that each of us has, we are called to be the body of Christ, and that we are joined together and knit together in every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promoting the body's growth and building itself up in love. And in doing so, we are to respect the unique individual gifts that each of us has. My wife, who works for hospice, often reminds the staff that she works with, and also the family members, that if you have the competency to make decisions, you also have the right to make decisions that are not necessarily healthy for you. That the individual has that right, and you and I are called to honor that and to allow them to do so, still staying there to support them and to help them if the difficulties become too great. We are also reminded that we are called to live in humility and gentleness, with patience bearing with one another in love. We are also called to affirm one another and affirm what is good in each other. In fact, a teacher in preschool says this is what she has learned about her students. If you see a picture of her class, there is a phone hanging on the wall, way back before we had cell phones, in which there is no cord attached to it. And early in the time in which she starts teaching each class, she learns who is their particular heroes or heroines. May it be Spider-Man, or may it be be the pop-ups or whomever it may be. One of my grandsons loves the Hulk. And he has a whole outfit of him. Then she'll notice as she goes around the room, if someone is doing something that is very positive that she wants to affirm, she'll go over and pick up the phone, put it up to her ear, and start speaking, saying, "Hello, Spider-Man. Yes, we're all doing great. But I especially want to tell you about Jimmy today. Jimmy is sitting very attentively, listening to Tommy describe the great weekend he and his family had. He has his eyes focused on Tommy, and he is enjoying the story that Tommy is telling." And she pretends to get off the phone, and she goes over to Jimmy and says, "Spider-Man says you're just doing a great job." And of course, he just beams. She also notices that in the course of the next few weeks, Jimmy does this over and over and over again. She also notices that the other children want to be her to call their favorite figure, and they start behaving in ways that are unique and special for them. In doing so, what she has done is created this positive image in her classroom. She's allowed each individual to become who they are, but also to reinforce that through this calling of their superhero. I think for each of us, we may not have a superhero. We may not have a phone without a cord on the wall. But I think each of us are called to do the same thing. We are called to reinforce that which is positive, that is positive in each of us. We are called in doing that to build up the body of Christ and to spread that Spirit of God that dwells in us and among us, so that we truly not only are parts of the body of Christ, but we are those parts that make it all that it can be. In doing so, we not only affirm ourselves, but we also affirm all those around us. As we continue to build up the body, may we truly be those instruments of affirmation, those instruments that call out the Spirit to recognize in each of us our special gifts and to rejoice in the uniqueness that each of us shares as living members of that body. If you are able, let us rise and profess our common faith. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally God and of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father.
us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our presiding bishop, our bishop, and for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those listed in our bulletin and for those we now name. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, for those who are present, and for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, those whose faith is known to you alone, that they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us command ourselves and one another and to our life, to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord, our God.
Almighty God, giver of every good gift, look graciously on your church, and so guide the minds of those who shall choose a rector for this parish, that we may receive a faithful pastor who will care for your people and equip us for our ministries through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us.
Give you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you. Have peace. walk in love as Christ loved us, and let us bring our gifts to the altar. Suns, the planets and their courses in this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, ever create, and have ever be.
For the primal elements who brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. He made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. Prophets and sages, you've revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood, he reconciled us. By his wounds, you are healed.
Therefore, we praise you, joining with our heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who've looked to you in hope. Proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn.
Oh,
And so, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving,
we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day to come.
Our God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only, and not for strength, for pardon only, and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Risen Lord, be none of us in the breaking of the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
Amen. Amen.
Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Let us take them in remembrance that Christ died for us, and let us feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
65 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God,
Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love us and serve you with gladness and singleness of our heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be generous to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, descend upon you and be with you forever.
Amen. Amen.